I love that you are committed to your growth. I love that you're here. It tells me a lot about your readiness. And I have had the privilege of working with brilliant women over the years, and I want to share with you what I have seen hold them back because they're the same things. So I'll share with them here so that you can be more mindful and not let them hold you back. And so perfectionism is a big one for women. Comparison, and we'll talk about that more in a moment, as well as self-doubt, like who am I to do this? Or not making decisions, right? Taking powerful action. And then the last one is, I'm not ready yet. I need another degree, or I need to postpone launching, or just taking the next intelligent step. But honey, you do not need to know the end in the beginning. The old ways of leadership are thinking that we need to be perfect before we start. They look outside of ourselves for our answers. And oftentimes when we do that, we can see other people that are further along in whatever we're wanting to endeavor, and then compare where we are, feeling not good enough and like we're not quite there yet, right? And that's gripping. Comparison is gripping. And just a side tip for you brilliant women, I see this all the time where you guys have such big visions for your future, but then you compare where you are in relation to it and it's deflating. And so once you get a clear strategic plan and you start taking action on it, don't look up for about 90 days and modify as you go, because otherwise it'll be preventing you from actually taking the next step. But we're being called into new ways of leadership where we take our power back over these limiting beliefs, where we choose authenticity over perfection. And when we see somebody that we're inspired by, we realize that they're actually reflecting to us parts of ourselves. This is about knowing that life is a mirror. So anything you see in somebody else is reflecting to you a part of yourself. Literally, anything you see outside of yourself is a mirror. It's reflecting to you a part of yourself. And you don't need to believe me. The psychological term for this is called a projection. But I would encourage you to test it out, to find out what your truth is, suspending any beliefs about it, so you can actually own your power and move forward feeling inspired and confident, having owned your greatness, and not just keep projecting it onto somebody else. So rather than supporting you in the old way of leadership, I want to support you in really claiming your inner leader. And as you claim your light and no longer project it onto other people, you feel more inspired, you feel empowered, and your action is much more powerful. So I'm going to walk you through a simple exercise to do this. And so take out a piece of paper or just walk with me through this process and think of who is one leader that you are most inspired by. Maybe it's Oprah or Mother Teresa or Gandhi. Who is it for you? Think about what are the qualities that inspire you about them. Maybe it's their courage or their authenticity. Maybe it's the impact that they've made in the world. So take a moment just to write down, what is it that really inspires you? What are the specific qualities? And now identify where in your life do you already demonstrate these qualities? So maybe it's authenticity and you think, well, I'm really authentic in my relationship. I really speak my truth to my partner. Or it could be impact. I've got a lot of impact. I really make a difference on my team. I show up, I feel really confident about that. So first it's about identifying what the qualities are and then how do I already demonstrate them in my life? Because as you start claiming your greatness, you're going to feel more empowered, but you're also gonna really see through the comparison mind. And then from there, once you're feeling more full and encouraged, then you can look at how else do I wanna express these qualities in my life? Right? So maybe it's, I want to be more courageous at work, or I want to have more impact in my relationship. But you can identify what the qualities are and let them inspire you rather than getting caught up in the mind around who does what in comparison to you, right? That's not helpful. I want to see you own your power rather than project it. And so I'm inviting you to this simple process. Identify what are the qualities that inspire you, just the qualities, so you don't get caught up in the people in comparison to where you are. What are the qualities? How do you already express it, right? Encouragement will help you move forward more gracefully. So how are you already demonstrating this? Especially as women, it's really easy to think about where we're not living up to that set point of what we see as imagined and ideal. So really acknowledging yourself and where you already demonstrate this in your life is so important. Don't skip this one. And then the last one, how or where would you like to express it more fully in your life? Maybe in your career, in your relationships. So what can you do? Share with us in the comments below. I would love to hear from you. Again, we support and inspire each other.